Hello dear students, welcome back in this online session of the lecture. Today I hope you all are fit and fine and you are sitting at home enjoying the virtual lecture which we are delivering you on this YouTube channel of Shantiniketan. And also if you go more further, after living well and after living fit and fine, the most thing is that we need to understand the daily routine diet. We should take the diet daily, get well, good sleep, and also do regular exercise as you are free right now at your home. But don't forget to see our lectures because it will help you for your examinations too, which is going to come very much near soon. So today's lecture is all depending on the class 9th, the sound of music, the shehnai of Ustad Bismillah Khan. Ustad is a word, or you can say that a respectful attachment tag with any name which describes that the personality is actually the pioneer of that art. That's why it is known as Ustad, or he is known as Ustad. So moving further here, the sound of music part 2, the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. In the previous lecture we studied about how he started to play Gilli Danda at his the age of 5 years old in Bihar, then how he went to other part of the area like Lucknow, or in the ceremonies where he became a very prominent accompanier of his own maternal uncle, and then he slowly started to play this Shehnai also. And what was the contemporary development and the invention of Shehnai, what is the basic relation of the Shehnai also with the Pungi, everything was studied in the previous lecture. If you have not seen the video, then you need to go and see the video number part 1 and part 2, as well this part 3 also. So if you go more further, as we know that this all the things are related with the person whose name is Ustad Bismillah Khan, and he also gave many more music in the films of Indian Bollywood, classical Sangeet too here, and also he got his first break in the All India Radio where he was somehow playing the national songs or related national tunes over the Air India Radio on air. So this was also one of the basic life history and the journey of Ustad Bismillah Khan. And now we'll see what kind of awards he got. I have written some of them according to the line wise, and I have also drawn this Shehnai so that you can understand which kind of category of the musical instrument which we are talking today in this lecture. So this is Shehnai. So students, if I talk about the awards, awards and recognition came thick and faster. Thick and faster means they came very very much closer to him when he became famous by his hard workship regarding the music. Now which kind of award he got, that we'll discuss in this whole lecture. First of all, we need to understand that who he became. Bismillah Khan, Ustad Bismillah Khan, became the first Indian to be invited to perform at the prestigious Lincoln Center. See, prestigious Lincoln Center Hall. Now this is itself a prestigious ceremony, or you can say prestigious invitation also to the person who are called. So where is this place? This is in the United States of America, USA, that you should remember out here. And apart from that, if you talk about in the United States of America, he also took part in the world explosion about the music here. Now explosions about the music means we can say in the Montreal he also took part, and in the Cannes, or we can say in the Cannes Art Festival, generally in the Cannes Art Festival, he also proved himself well that yes, he is not only the person who can play the music in a simple and a general way, he can build up the music, he can generally magnify the music, and he can make it more attractive. So he was relating with that kind of personality, means he himself was that kind of personality. So at the art festival which held at the Osaka, as I written in the trade fair Montreal. So now this was not only end, so well he went more on further, so well known did he become internationally famous than an artist, or than an auditorium was also named after him, which was in Tehran. This thing you need to underline in your notebook. An auditorium, see here, in the Tehran was named after him. Tahar Mosque, iska naam pura tha, Tahar Mosque Ustad Bismillah Khan. So that was also in the Tehran. It was named after him. Now whenever you are actually naming any institute, building, roadways, or a road marg, or any airport on the name of any personality, you need to understand that the person's name or the person should be very very worldwide known, and he has also he may have also given very good terms of new technique, new belief or invention in a different category of the field, so as it was also done by Ustad Bismillah Khan. Therefore, Tehran, one of the auditorium, was named after his name, means on his name only. Now, national awards were also somehow got by this person whose name was Ustad Bismillah Khan. Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, and we can say that other award also were conferred to him. His all the life journey was struggling, luxurious, and somehow we can say that traveling his life, and related to the other fact also, and he was also a live model of that time and today also, that if you think to be something unique, to do something unique, you need to work hard, you need to burn yourself. So moving further here, in 2001, if I talk about in 2001, Ustad Bismillah Khan was awarded as the India's highest civilian award to here. Highest civilian award means he was one of the great personality of India as well. He also got the Bharat Ratna. You can see in the textbook, he also got the Bharat Ratna with the coveted award. Somehow we can say that somehow with the resting with the all natural, or we can say resting with the every happiness on his chest, as he says that, and with his eyes glittering with the rare happiness, he said that all I would like to say is teach your children music. This is Hindustan's richest tradition ever I have seen, or even in the West, this is somehow coming to learn our music. He said this thing when he went to get his Bharat Ratna. See, whenever you are going to get any kind of award, you are giving your motivational speech. Now, with the glittering eyes and the very proudfulness on his chest, he says that, please, my dear, all the Indians, forget Hindus and Muslims, forget your caste. First of all, you should remember that you need to give something to your kids, and that is the talent. Teach your kids the Hindustani music. These Britishers, European people are also going to come and learn this music. It is divine. It is extraordinary. So this is a theory where he was also leading with his own belief and techniques. And if I go more further, he was, in spite of having traveled all over the world, he was also wishing to accompany the great musicians, and also he was wishing to give his masses to everyone so that everybody can go on his own footprint. So my dear students here, in spite of having traveled all over the world, Khan Sahab, means Ustad Bismillah Khan, as he is fondly called, exactingly fond of Banaras, he says that at where he was leaving Dumrao, he was that, and they remain for him most wonderful town. As he was asked, he says that I still miss my state, I still miss my country, and he wanted to again go back there, as he was heading a school in US of Sehnai and teaching the Britishers also, and the student promised to recreate the atmosphere of Banaras, replicating the same musical tone in US. As he was being asked by the students or the other people that what you miss most, and he said that, so giving the same atmosphere, students of his own also gave him a dedication that they made the whole atmosphere like Banaras in the US. And somehow Bhat Khan Sahab was asked him if he would be able to transport river Ganga as well, like he transported the music from India to US. Later he is also somehow we can remember to have which is said by him that, okay, that is what I whenever think that, as he was asked that, sir, will you able to transfer Ganga also in this jokey way to the US, as you have transported your Indian classical music to US? He says that, okay, as I have seen the Ganga, I have learned many more things, and we can say that that is why whenever I am in the foreign country, I miss the Ganga. He said that, okay, if I would be able to transport Ganga to US, it will be not possible, because India is the best place to flow of Ganga, to make a flow of Ganga, or to generate or to maintain the flow of Ganga, because it is rich, it is really with a culture, manner and ritual civilizations here. So he's also telling that, okay, if he would be transport a river Ganga as well. And later he is telling that, okay, remember to have said that is why the whenever I am in foreign country, I keep thinking of my own nation. Still I miss that nation, because the way I learned music at the river Ganga is also one of the mesmerizing thing for me. is also one of the marvelous thing for me, as he says in his lecture. And therefore he is ending that, whenever I miss India, whenever I need to see India, I feel that I still needed to go in India, I still needed to work with the Indian people. And also still he says that, see Hindustan here also in my heart. While in the Mumbai, when I am in the US, I say Hindustan, but whenever I am in Mumbai, I think only of Banaras, he's saying, and the holy river Ganga, which I cannot transport. And also when I am in Banaras, he's telling that, okay, when I am in Banaras, I miss my unique Mattha of Durao. Okay, of the Dumrao. Mattha means what? That's a buttermilk. Okay, it's a chhas in the Gujarati called. So he's telling that I miss my village. When he is in US, he miss India. When he is in Mumbai, he is missing his Banaras. When he is in Banaras, he is missing his Bihar's Mattha, his Dumrao's Mattha. So that's also Ustad Bismillah Khan's life is a perfect example, we can say, of the richness of the hard work, leadership of the music, and also with the heritage development of the India. And if you go more further, effortlessly he accepts that a devotee, since from the Muslim, likely he is very naturally to play Shehnai every morning at the Kashi Vaikunthnath temple, or we can say Vishwasnath temple also. Being a Muslim person also, he is supporting that. It means, here is a message for you all, to go and support any nations or any religion is not like that you are hurting your own religion and you are destructing your own religion. It's not like that. Hindus, Muslims, Sikh, Isai, Christians, apart from the qom, we all are Indians and we all are brothers and sisters. So if Ustad Bismillah Khan, though a big personality, can go and give his music to the Vishwanath temple, Vaikunth temple and Shiva temple, obviously everybody can visit everybody's places, and they can also somehow support each other religiously without fighting with each other. So this lecture was all related with this theories about the lesson, my dear student. And it was not only related with the music, it is also giving you the best companionship of the friendship, national brotherhood also, international brotherhood also, hard work, leadership and many more things. So here we are ending the chapter, and also we are making very best examples in this chapter we learned also, and we'll imply that kind of things in our lesson and in our life lesson that I hope from you and from me also. We'll meet in the other lecture. Till then you can keep revising. Jai Hind. And also keep focusing on your daily lectures which are coming on the YouTube channel of Ashanti Niketan. So once again, Jai Hind, and take care. See you in the next lecture.